Hello, secret character tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force 3 with me, Blue Ankylo. So today is the day we're going to find out who that secret character is in the runes that we've been talking about for a couple episodes. I didn't want to spoil it for you guys, so hopefully you'll be super impressed when we see him. Or her, I don't want to spoil it. Anyway, right now we've got the B team guarding the ruins entrance, just luring out a couple enemies here and there. For now, we'll probably do a little bit of healing up, so we're probably not going to push forward just yet. And I might try to lure another harpy down in a second. Maybe if I stand Symbios over here or something. And luckily, his illusion wore off. That's good. We're getting Grace to top everybody's HP up, because why not? She's got to level up. And I think that'll do. Probably could lure... You know, we could probably start pushing forward a little bit with this group. The enemy don't seem too strong. I worry a little bit about splitting the party, because sometimes a bunch of enemies will ambush us out of nowhere. And if you've only got like 4 or 5 people, you might have a hard time. Oh, he didn't escape. Maybe we can kill him. Hey, the Gale Lance! That one is important. We do need that. And I know for sure the next chest over here is very important as well. In fact, it'd be nice for Dauntless to get the Gale Lance, because that's going to be his one day. Today, hopefully. So he's taken some hits. Let's see, how do I want to do this? Is the thief going to be able to... The thief will probably get the second item this turn as well. We could finish this guy off, just for the XP. We're going to have Obright and Horst probably able to kill this guy. There's not much else other than the Hydra. And someone needs to find our hidden character, too. You know what? I'll have Dauntless move up. He might trigger some new enemies as well. It'd be nice to know what's going to happen. Use a healing drop here. It's not necessary, but just in case a bunch of enemies drop on top of us. You know, there could be like a Wyvern or something, right? I don't think Irene really wants to 1v1 a Hydra. Sybil, I'm gonna have her kill this guy. Assuming she hits, she'll kill him. There is no escape from these ruins, thief. You get some money, you get a little bit of XP. May as well if you can, right? Alright, Obright. Start beating up these Bloodborne. Maybe you get a counter kill or something awesome? Aw, oh, don't get paralyzed. Well, somebody had... Well, actually, Irene might be able to actually cure that next turn, so... I know we've got, like, a couple antidote herbs spread around. I think Sybil had one, but I probably threw it away, unfortunately. Alright, Ratchet. Let's start fighting this guy. Yeah, I don't think I want Ratchet to hit the thief anyway, so... Sure, I'm pretty sure Ratchet can take one hit from the lizard. And this might blind it or something. Look at that! Lost an illusion, so hopefully it will just miss on its turn. Cool. So the harpy did not fly down. I'm always a little bit worried about these flying enemies that can kind of do whatever they want. I know that lizard man seemed to be moving forward, so we'll just sort of position the forward force this side a little bit. Try to be a little bit cautious about the harpy, because it could always fly down whenever it wants. And we'll just keep topping people up with Grace. Mascarin probably has a bit less defense, so. She's got some pretty awesome shoulder pads now. It's more likely the Lizard Man will go after Symbios. Yeah, there he comes. So next turn we can probably beat him up. Back to the ruins! Alright, the last chest, the Wendigo Rod is, or the Wendigo Wand, is something Noon would like a lot. So, there's two things. I need to not kill him in one more hit, and I need to find our ally before we do kill him. So I'm going to put a save down, both a full save and a save state. And I'm going to try to hit him with his lowest strength weapon, which is the halberd, or the lance, I believe. So 54, it should do around 25 damage, which shouldn't kill it, unless something like this happens. So that's why we put a save down, because that's not going to work. So, that's great. Thanks, Dontrez, you're just too strong. Who's paralyzed? Where does it even tell you? Oh, body is paralyzed, it's on stats, okay. Well, luckily I've got one sort of reserve fairy powder here. So I think if Dontrez had been a little bit less powerful there, we could have gotten what we wanted already. Well, at least one of the items, but we have lots of people to block the road anyway next turn. So I don't think we need to stress out about it. Oh right, I forgot about the Lizard Man. It's gonna miss. Or block, same difference. Ratchet would probably kill him. I could switch to the anchor. Again, we'll give it a shot. He can make it close enough for the anchor to have a chance. Anchor is fairly low damage. I'll just put another save state in here to save some time. As long as we don't get a skill activation, it should be okay.
We die.
Yeah. Good. And that'll get us our lance. Cool. So, you know, it's not the worst. It's a little bit hard to tell if Dontrez is going to one-shot someone, but even if the numbers check out, he still does so much damage on his skills. I'd really like Mascarin to learn some new magic. Again, oop, no, I misclicked, that was my bad. I'm pretty sure the Lizard Men are weaker to ice than fire. I'm going to try out one of those spells. What I didn't finish saying, but I was thinking, was that I do want Mascarin to get a couple more levels up, because I think she gets a new spell before too much longer. I think Grace is maybe one level off of a good spell for her. It's getting close either way. Alright, well, Symbios can get the kill. I'm sure he won't complain.
Huh?
You usually want your leader at the highest level, or nearly the highest level anyway. Power axes seem to be dropping all over the place. I guess I probably won't need the antidote herb. It's worth a little bit more to have, I think you can sell them for, what was it, 700 gold or something like that? You know, it's alright. So this should be the final turn of the ruins. He did not escape. Now, I would love to let Dontrez kill him and steal his... Or, oh no, the lance went to Ratchet. Oh, I thought it went in the other order, but I was thinking, you know, Dantres would just go and take his lance, but... where the heck? Ah, it is by this one. I thought I checked, but... oh, you know what it was? Is I put Ratchet beside him, beside this pillar, but it had... he had someone he could attack, so it was just automatically up here. So I didn't check that you could have inspected. Whatever. How did you find me? Clever, you saw through my ruse. If you're from the Momochi, I'll see to it that you never turn me in. Yep, we found a ninja. I'm a rogue ninja from the Momochi clan. Many have tried to bring me in. Are you not bounty hunters? Apparently we're not bounty hunters, so he's happy to join. Help me remain free, and in return I, Hagane, will use my skills as a ninja to help your cause. Oof. In a puff of explosion. It's pretty cool, right? Everybody wants a ninja on the force. I think so. Alright, so Sybil, it doesn't even matter how much damage you do, you just have to give up a fairy powder, and nobody cares about that. Bring him down!
Get ready!
It's no lightning strike, but it's pretty good. Right, and I will definitely bring the Wendigo Rod. So the Wendigo Rod, well, or the wand, sorry. It's good. We'll talk about it once I get it to noon. It's probably about his best wand in this scenario. There's another wand that can give him luck, which is fine if you're trying to do status ailments. But as far as good spells go, the Wendigo Rod wand is probably better. One of these days, that harpy's gonna nail me. Well, you go ahead, Eldar, you'll be fine. It's not like I got you killed last episode or anything, right? Okay, show off. Eldar says, not this day. I shall not die. And I shall not get any friend points either. Let's make sure I can trade this over. I want to make sure Noon gets his item. And Grace, you know, just healing people up. Just farming that XP. There could be a good argument for me to stop doing this, because we might need the MP to heal when we get to the boss. And this is a really long map, so I think I will stop, actually. I want to make sure we've got at least a couple turns of proper healing magic. I wonder if I should have gone up the ramp. Let me double check the map here when we get a turn. So if I'd gone up the ramp, I'd kind of be, you know, hit by both sides, and it's a really nasty choke point. People can't go up there very quickly. If we go the long way, there might be an ambush here, but we'll always be fighting the enemies sort of one group at a time. So I think it's the safer way. This is also the more boring way. All right, we just have to wait a little bit longer here. Alright, so Don Therese does not have it. He needs his lance, so... Who is it? Ratchet has it? Yeah, Ratchet has his lance. He can have that traded over, or... Yeah, he's got a spot. Grace, I'm gonna start saving your MP now, because I've only got 7 heals left. Irene... I would really like to have enough MP for a resist before we get to the boss, so I'd like to save some of her MP as well. We can't really aggress now. Oh, good. Oh, good! But it probably does magic damage, so it doesn't hurt as bad. So that was actually totally fine. If we aggress now, I think we might lose Hagane permanently. Like, we have to win the map after talking to him. So, that's what I'm thinking anyway.
Talk?
There you go, Symbios. Saving the finishing blow for someone else. What a nice guy. Alright, Sybil. You've got the Wendigo Rod. Could have actually had Noon Park get a little bit further. You can see here that it's a pretty significant upgrade. I'll have him do it himself so we can see. Yeah, Harpies, not so good against bows, are you? Nice to see the force all getting to the same kind of level up. Obrite is a little bit behind. That's pretty standard for my my gladiators. Like I've said since we got him, really, because he goes last so often, there's rarely any enemies left for him to kill. Which is, you know, probably a good thing. It's just he lags behind a little bit. It wasn't Obrite, right? It was Ratchet. Yeah. And I mean, a good number of our characters do have a healing drop of some sort, so I don't have to rely on the healers only to do the healing. There you go. Dontre is going to get a pretty awesome new weapon. He'll equip it himself next turn, so you can see. Now, Eldar is getting a little bit ahead of the show, so I'll move her sort of one more time, but I think I want the group to catch up. Because, of course, there's an ambush. And no one is surprised. Maskrin. I'm not going to heal up. 31 is lots. We're not going to get one shot by that. So, let's have a look at this weapon. So, the Wendigo Rod, wand, whatever, obviously has more attack and a huge defense boost. That's pretty cool. It's going to give him a new spell, and it should go from a B rank magic boost to an A rank magic boost. So, for instance, his free spell, 21-23... should go up here a bit. Look at the stats one more time. And, okay, it went up by one. It's not that impressive, but I think it has a larger difference when he gets to level 3 with his wand. It also gives him the Wendigo summon, which I'm pretty sure is ice elemental and a summon. So, it does way more damage than anything else we've got right now. And it will split damage between adjacent enemies if you cast it on a group, which is not as good. It'll do the same damage as, like, you know, freeze level 2. But it's cool. I like summons, even if they're not always as useful as just the basic spells. I like them. And then Dontrez, of course. So he's got... normally, he would have a lance, and now he can equip a Gale Lance. So it gives him some more agility and a pretty good attack boost, and I can use it for support level 2, which gives, if everyone's grouped up, basically the entire group will get the plus defense, plus agility. It'll have the wide range, like Spark 2, so it's pretty good. You know, it's not bad. It might not be the best lance in the game, but it's not bad. Nah, 30 is fine. I'll stop wasting MP too much. So I think, who is missing mithril weapons now? Oh, I thought someone from Flagard was coming to escort me. So, is it you, Symbios? Finally, you show your face, Palsis. If you are here, that must mean... Oh my. Lord Conrad, tell me, is he alright? Not so. Since the Walkure headed south, heralding the awakening of Bulzom, I feared this would happen. Now, your present presence confirms my predictions. Before Lord Conrad passed away, he told us to come to you, Duke Palsis, and protect you from Bulzom. I made a promise to Conrad that if anything should ever happen to him, I would mentor Symbios. I prayed this day would never come. Unfortunately, that promise can't be kept now that I'm here. And you went to the trouble of coming all the way out here to kill me. Fial, High Priest of Bulzom, how thoughtful of you. But how do you know my name? Your knowledge is indeed vast. All the more reason for our little chat. I'm afraid your idea of chatting requires blind obedience or brainwashing. Either way, I'd rather not thank you. If that's the case, join Symbios in the grave, my intellectual duke. I'm sure he'll be fine, right? I don't have to rush up there. He could be killed in one hit if they attacked him. I sure hope they don't attack him, because there's nothing I can do right now. I can't shoot arrows up the wall here. We'll find out shortly. Gotta love those life rings. So good. Yeah, they seem to just ignore him. Oh, good! Flyers. Ah, special attack. That's fine. That's nothing. That's nothing. I should really try to get the force grouped up a little bit better here, though. Kind of spread thin. Alright, let's hold off, make sure this guy dies.
Hyper boom!
Thanks, Eldar. Yep, you can do 60 damage now, good for you. You're a big girl. It's like, seriously, now that I want to get friendship points with her, she's just killing everything in one hit. They can move, like, two more. If they want to attack Symbios here, I'll let them. We'll keep Hayward back a little bit. I probably should heal him now. Good. Come at me, bro. This is but a scratch. Ratchet. I don't know if giving him the running pimento was the right idea, but it's pretty cool seeing him zip around like that. So let's see how this Nelson, or it's not Nelson Lance, it's Gale Lance. One of the translations calls it the Nelson Lance, but Gale Lance sounds pretty good. Alright, you know, no skills, just about one shot a mass monk. Yeah, that's pretty good. What do you think, Eldar? You want to finish it off? Why not? There you go, Eldar. I think you were the first of the new batch to level 7. Are you proud, bird girl? Let's have a quick look at her stats, just for interest's sake here. Yeah, that's pretty ridiculous, actually. Now, if you didn't buy her a mithril weapon, And you didn't give her a mithril accessory, she wouldn't be that awesome. I also gave her, like, the armor milk and the power wine and everything. But at this point, I think her stats have gone high enough that she's pretty much the best Bird Knight you've ever seen, right? She might not quite be Peter levels because he's a phoenix, but as far as all the... What were they all called? I forget all their names, but Balbaroi and Amon and Screech and Luke. I remember all their names. I'm good. I think she's probably the best of all four of them nowadays. It's because she's got mithril weapons. Pretty awesome. Well, it's not just the mithril weapons. But her hyper boom game is a pretty awesome skill by the looks of it. Right, throw Sybil over here. Gonna throw Symbios up front a little bit. Obviously, they can't even really hurt him, so that's fair. We'll keep Hayward a little bit safe. I don't know how many more of these guys are just gonna spawn out of nowhere, so we're gonna be a little bit careful. You can try again here? Oh, that's gonna do some damage. Wasting my antidotes, buddy. Still waiting for Albright to catch up. Poor level 4 Albright. Alright, so Hatchet. He got to level 2 with his weapons, right? Level 2 anchor. And he's got a mithril. I could buy him a mithril anchor, I suppose, but the level 3 shell is probably. Or sorry, the mithril shell with range 3 is probably better, seeing as anchors only ever get to level range 2. Unless you need that axe bonus, but it's not the case in this situation. Take a shot. Power surge. Good. That's a acceptable amount of damage so that one person doesn't get all the kills. And Eldar, honestly, you've gotten to the point where you no longer need to be fed anything.
Twister!
Twist and shout, baby. Yeah, she's looking strong. She actually got to level 7 before the mighty Don Terez. And that is definitely saying something. Not gonna pick anything up for that. Or not gonna drop anything for that. So I sort of missed a kill with Mascarin before that I meant to get because I misclicked. Pretty sure she can do 13 damage to a Mask Monk with Blaze 1.
Here I come.
Yeah, not a problem. She does not. Who's got? There's got to be a couple people that have some antidote herbs of some sort, right? Okay, so Hayward can cure the poison on whoever it was. Symbios? Yeah. Just gonna try to save a little bit of MP at this point. How dare you spawn in the middle of nowhere? Sybil, take him out!
Get ready!
Yeah, that's because the Arc Halberd is ridiculously good. It doesn't even matter that she only gets plus one attack. The Arc Halberd's got it. Alright, so you're poisoned. Whatever, you're fine. Take him out, Symbios. Or just do a little bit of damage. That's fine. At least you gotta level up, right? Ooh, 7 damage. I meant to do an attack there. That was my bad. I wonder if poison must... I don't even wonder. Poison must be a percentage of your total HP, I guess. Which I suppose makes sense, but it's just different than what it used to be in the previous Shining Forces. I think in Shining Force 1 and 2, poison just always does 2 or 3 damage and that's it per round. I think. Now you're already level 7. Do you have a... You don't have an antidote. Only people below level 7 are allowed to kill those monks. That's my rule. Don Therese, you can go kill one. Good, my team of level 7ers continues to grow. I really would like an antidote herb. If she kills it... Oh, right. I should have done this the other way. I should have had Don Therese attack this one. Oh, well, I'm not going to start wasting tons of MP. We'll just do some damage. There's no need to rush this, I don't think. Although, I probably need to end the episode. Shoot. We'll go a little bit longer here, just so that I know next time we're going to be able to finish this battle. I'll pull somebody else back for now. Okay, Grace is gonna handle the HP part of this. Someone else has gotta have an antidote herb that she can, that can be used to get rid of that poison. That poison is doing tons of damage. Gonna hold the line. Yeah, I meant to have Hayward attack one last round, and that would have probably resulted in this guy being dead by now. But we'll be fine. Straight for Symbios. Joke's on you. He's already poisoned, and you can't really hurt him otherwise. We're gonna get a little bit of grinding here for a minute. Okay, this is actually good because Obrite's one of the ones that needs some XP anyway. I mean, if I can get everyone up to level 7 right here, I'll be pretty happy. Or even higher. Yeah, I'm gonna use his weaker axe. His revenge mace is just too strong. So I think Horst is our first level 8er. Well, we could obviously get one more right now if I wanted it. I think I can get Symbios to kill that guy, so I'd rather that. Or, sorry, Mascarin. Mascarin can certainly kill one of these. Maybe I'll let Irene get a kill too here, actually. Yeah, let's do that. Dontrez is all leveled up. Someone was supposed to be curing the poison. Which I obviously did not do. So let's go with... Well, I want to make sure she kills it. So I'll burn a little bit of MP here just to guarantee it. I probably could have gone with a weaker spell, but... Hey, friends with Horst is friends for life, right? very pitiful MP growth. I'm not impressed by that. I don't know what the deal is. I do need to show off Wendigo, but it's pretty expensive, so I don't want to waste it. It's okay, it's just gonna burn for a little bit longer. You know what, I might end up using that, I have that goddess tier that restores MP. I might end up giving that to Grace. Just because, I do need to win this map right now. And she's starting to run low. It's my own fault, but... Alright, here you go. Irene? Show 'em what's what. There we go. Now we got a free antidote herb. Typical, right? Alright, well, I think we're gonna need to end the episode here. Let's get to the end of the round, but this has been a big map, so we're gonna have to split it up again. And I think Horst or Ratchet will be the last, I guess. Palsis is super slow. Anyway, Dontrez with his fancy Gale Lance goes real quick nowadays. Anyway, thanks for watching, folks. I think we're in good shape. I'm a little bit worried about Fial because he's got Wendigo level 2, which is tricky. Like, the key here is Wendigo 2, you need to keep your team grouped up. Because if they're alone, the single target damage will just one-shot them. I think it'll... I'm just going to ballpark at around 50 or 60 damage. The problem then is you have to group everyone up so you can use Spark level 2, which hits everyone for 20 damage. And I was really hoping that Grace would hit level 7, which I could probably set up if I let her kill a couple things, because I think she gets a spell that would counter the bolt a little bit. Anyway, we'll worry about that next episode. So thanks for watching and all that. Hope you guys are enjoying, and I'll see you next time.